The capital of one of the largest empires in history. Agricultural depression, worsened by free trade and increasing imports of cheap food from America and the colonies. People migrate from the rural side on the pursuit of opportunities and a better life. Accelerated urban growth. Urban networks stretch. Places of industry get consolidated. Those who can afford transportation are separated from those who rely on nearby housing. The city is overcrowded now. The air is polluted. The necessity of a new form of settlement in which both urban and rural society could be rebuilt and reintegrated. An inventor with no professional qualifications, a social reformer. With ideas for an enlightened life and good intentions. Two dysfunctional poles, a third magnet. The birth of a utopia.
Town and country must be married.
A garden city
and
is
out
conceived.
Of this joyous union will spring a new hope, a new life, a new civilization.
Processes. The global economy has led the urban world to a new era. Market-driven, market-disciplinary strategies and new policies are mobilized to strengthen the socio-economic assets of the urban center. The city has become a major node in the interconnected systems of information and money. Peripheries and margins were increasingly left to their own. Neoliberal geography of inequality and polarization. The city's docks activities moved further down the river. The architecture of extreme capitalism first began.
Years, the gap between the richest 10% and the poorest 10% in this country has widened substantially. How can she say at the end of her chapter in British politics that she can justify many people in the constituency such as mine being relatively much poorer, much less well housed, and much less well provided than it was in 1979? Surely she accepts that is not a record that she or any prime minister can be proud of.
Mr. Speaker, all levels of income are better off than they were in 1979. But what the honourable member is saying is that he would rather the poor were poorer, provided the rich were less rich. That way you will never create the wealth for better social services as we have. And what a policy! Yes, he would rather have the poor poorer, provided the rich were...
Cultural and creative industries represent a significant catalyst in the economic dynamics of the inner city. Unemployment, displacement of locals and in the process the elimination of a sense of place and identity. The city has polarized, human struggle for territory. The city excludes most of its inhabitants. The countryside has become a commuter place, an extension of the city. The first garden city resembles car-based suburbia.
Urban failed, rural failed, where will the people go? Garden City V2.0, the emergence of a new urban model, the resurgence of the Hadean ideals, an updated version, where we are all connected.
Garden City V2.0 speculates on a possible future scenario where people are empowered with new tools to create self-sustainable and democratic settlements. The prototype city is presented as an open-source platform where a new anarchist and independent type of community can be created. a global community based on the social and economic principles of Ebenezer Howard, but technologically enabled to fully self-build a programless city that can be flexible enough to adapt to the coming changes and face some of today's global housing struggles. The form and function of architecture is no longer relevant to living. The city is no longer a unity dominated by architecture, but broken into fragments. Inhabitation happens in a rather radical way.